You don't have to live with the lousy object models. This class is not object-oriented. It is not functional either. It is nothing in particular. The first problem I observe is the data representation. This class is modeling the publication status of a book in a bookstore application. How do we understand the combination of a nullable object and a Boolean flag? Three static factory methods try to help clear the confusion. The book is either published on a date, planned for a date, or not published yet with no upcoming date specified. This design has plugged even worse issues. You can watch the previous videos in this series on turning an anemic domain model into an object-oriented one. The links to all the videos are in the description. My general advice when turning an anemic domain model into an object-oriented one is to start from the bottom up. The small objects would then grow into larger ones. But let me not spoil the surprise. This is that mysterious date class at the bottom of this object model. It models a range of dates. Hence, two Boolean flags help model the missing parts. Another three static factory methods create a full date, an entire month, or an entire year. This class models often incomplete data about the book. It is equally not object-oriented as the class that uses it. You will observe the troubles if you try to use this class. You can imagine requests in the backlog depending on date ranges. This property getter should return the first date from the range. A larger feature requires that. Luckily, I have already modeled each range by specifying its first date. Oh, that was smart indeed. Then some other feature needs the next date interval of the same kind. The luck is deserting me on this. I will need to analyze the content of the object before deciding. With both month and a day, it is the proper date, so I return the next day. With only the month and the no day, I need to roll over the 12th month. This is one carefully crafted expression. The last case is just a year. Pick the following year. Think about this implementation while I add one more operation. Calculating the inclusive upper bound of a range. It is the day before the beginning of the next interval. I have completed the features, but there are several red flags on this screen. Do you see them? Can you identify what's wrong with this design? Here is how I see it. I have implemented every feature using different means. There is no consistent programming method at work here. This property is the composition of the prior ones. I can approve that. The one above is a hover. It analyzes the combinations of values to decide the outcome. And the one at the top is a coding trick. If I changed how I encode incomplete states, like in this place here, that property would stop working correctly. I don't like this kind of programming. In a project with 1,000 classes, every now and then, you will encounter a request that has no solution using clever tricks. You will start cutting corners, I know. Cut 100 corners and you will be in a deep, deep trouble. You have seen that already, I know. So let's redesign this class after all. There will be no clever tricks from this point on. The principal issue with the old implementation is that it did not acknowledge that this class represented three distinct things. This is a screaming sign of an abstraction. Let it be an abstract class for now. It could be a full date. It gives a domain meaning to the date-only instance. It could be a year accompanied by a month with no day number. Lastly, it could be just a year. Can you see the simplicity of modeling state this way? Understand the state and the methods will follow. I will now focus on behavior. First of all, there is no behavior in the base class. There is no point in having subclasses. Subclassing is an inheritance relationship. There must be something to inherit from the base class, but there is nothing here. It is natural to turn such an abstraction into an interface, clean and tidy. The interface would declare the public members, the beginning and next properties, then the last date of property comes. But look, a universally correct implementation exists across all possible implementations. Let me utilize the default interface implementation so that concrete classes can skip repeating this logic unless they know a better way. We have separated the declaration from concrete implementations. The full date already represents its own beginning. The next full date is just the next calendar date. That was easy. Also, this class knows how to calculate the last date more optimally. The full date is already its own end. How about implementing the year-month variant? The beginning is the first of the month. Easy. The next month requires that rollover calculation. The year variant will be even easier to implement. It begins on January the 1st, of course. The next one is just the following year, of course. And its inclusive end is December the 31st, of course. Do you see any problem with writing code like this? There is nothing to branch around on this screen. Every variant of every operation has just one way to happen. Now move all these concrete classes into a sub-name space and discover the true look of the feature. It is just an interface. It tells me everything I need to know before using it. Many people complain about adding classes. They fail to realize that this process is not about adding classes. It is about removing code into a sub-name space, which you probably won't open ever again. You might be interested in the persistence of these types too. The underlying database schema did not change after I substituted the class with the interface. You can download the entire source code from my Patreon page and read it. Please remember that every registered patron is helping hundreds of other fellow programmers watch these videos for free. There is a lot more in the final code than what I can show in this video, so please visit my Patreon page and read it all there. Now, in the bottom-up redesigning style, we step into the class that uses this new abstraction. Using the interface is just a detail. There is more in redesigning this class, which will differ greatly from the prior redesign. It will begin the same though, turn the class abstract, then discover its true variants. The published book comes with a date on which it was published. The planned book also has a date, but its name and meaning differ. These two dates are not interchangeable, you see. That is the fine print when modeling classes. A future date should not be allowed for a printed book. Conversely, a planned date would probably start in the future, but it could slip into the past later. We would say the book was planned, but now its printing is overdue. You see, the containing class gives meaning to the smaller type. Nevertheless, the third variant is a book with no assigned publishing date. The date used to be nullable before. Now, it's not even an object. When I delete the old implementation, we notice again that the subclasses inherit nothing from the base. The base type will once again become an interface. How will other classes use this interface now? Shall I expose that nullable partial date again and leave dealing with it to the consumer? Oh no, no, we should know better than this. When you return a nullable reference, everybody must branch around the null. Why? I will now show you a better idea. There will be no branching, yet everything will happen predictably every time. You can add a touch of functional design to a class. This new method would optionally map the contained date, if available, into a yet unknown type T. It will do so by passing the date, if available, through a mapping function. This is a higher order function. However, the date might not exist. The caller would have to supply a viable substitute for its use case. For the sake of completeness, I will also add a corresponding method that accepts the action and produces no result. This is an entirely new mindset, which I hope you will accept in time. So many things in C# are moving in this direction already. Don't be the last one to figure it out. How shall I implement the map method in a published book then? There is a date, so just apply the mapping. The action would follow the same way. It goes the same with the planned book. There's nothing unusual here yet. These two classes used to be the non-null cases in the design based on a nullable reference. The change comes with a class that has no date whatsoever. What shall the map method do then? Oh, it's easy. Return the substitute. And how about the action? It's even easier. Don't call the action. Do nothing with the date because there is none. This is the full implementation of an extendable set of types modeling the publication state of a book with or without an associated date. After moving the implementations deeper into the tree of namespaces, these three lines of code are all you need to know to use them all. You can work on this project for a decade longer and never open the implementation sub-namespaces. I'm telling this from experience. Cover them with a handful of tests and forget about them. Let me show you just one point in the application that requires a calculation of dates. There are several points similar to this one. This web API endpoint allows the caller to specify how to sort the books in the response. In a proper object-oriented design, all I should do is find an object that implements the comparison feature which order by will utilize. That is the principal trait of object-oriented design. Give me the object whose responsibility is what I need here. This is the publication information by which I need to sort. The customer's request says I should take the beginning of each date range as the reference date for sorting. Furthermore, if the book has no date assigned, treat it as a future work and put it far into the future. It would end up first in the sort order. That is what the customers have requested. I may extract the calculation into a helper method and use it in both places where sorting is requested. Now observe the separation of concerns, which is a principal trait of object-oriented design. This code's responsibility is to choose the sort order and the substitute date. Two interfaces offer abstract operations. We don't know what these will do, but we know it will be correct, so why bother to read their implementation details?